Hi, lifelong learners. Are you smart enough to answer all six questions from Poundstone's Are You Smart Enough to Work at Google? Most people cannot answer three correctly. All of these questions are used in interviews by top companies like Microsoft, Google, and Amazon. So good luck, you have been warned. You get on a ski lift at the bottom of the mountain and take it all the way to the top. What proportion of lift chairs do you pass on the way up? The answer? All of them. At the beginning, you pass the chair directly behind you on the cable. And just before you exit, you pass the chair directly in front. That is now on its way back down the mountain. Are you ready to continue? Why are manhole covers round? The answer? Because a round manhole cover cannot fall down an open hole. Let's move on. We're starting to get more difficult now. What is next in this series? SSS, SCC, C, SC. The answer? SSSS. This series is actually the alphabet in code. Capital A equals SSS because it has three straight lines. B is SCC because it has one straight line and two curves. So C is C because it has one curve. And D is SC because it has one curve and one straight line. The next is SSSS because E has four straight lines. These are getting tricky now. Here is a series of numbers. What row of numbers comes next? The answer, 312211. To understand this puzzle, you need to say the numbers out loud. The first line has 11, so the second line becomes 11. Spoken aloud, the second line has two ones. So the third line is 21. Spoken aloud, the third line has 12 and 11, which becomes the fourth line. And the final line has 3 ones, 2 twos, and 11, which becomes the answer. Second last question now. You are in a car with a helium balloon tied to the floor. The windows are closed. When you start to accelerate, what happens to the balloon? Does it move forward, backwards, or stay still? The answer? Forward. Helium balloons float because helium is lighter than air. When you accelerate, the air is pushed backwards, in the same way that your body is. This means the balloon will go forward. The opposite happens when you brake. The balloon will move backwards. And the last and most difficult question? You are shrunk to the height of a coin and thrown in an empty blender. The blades will start moving in 60 seconds. How do you escape? The answer? Jump. If you have ever played with rockets, you may know that two rockets strapped together do not go higher than a single rocket, because while you have doubled the power, you have doubled the weight. By the same principle, if you were shrunk, but your power and weight remained in the same proportion, then the height you can jump is the same. Thus, you could jump out. Did you manage to answer three or more correctly? Post below. If you enjoyed this video, I recommend Poundstone's book. It contains more detailed explanations and many other questions. I've included a link to it on Amazon. Give us a thumbs up and subscribe by clicking the button and the bell below. Thanks for watching.